Hi, I'm Nicholas. I love being with plants. I find the leaves of the trees interesting. Their different designs, their different shapes, the way dew rolls on the leaves, the way leaves change color with the change in season. Leaves are also interesting because of their veins. Today, let's talk about veins. The veins of a leaf support the lamina, and the way the veins are arranged on the leaf is called as venation. There are two types of venation. The one that we are most familiar with, in which they form a net-like pattern, is known as reticulate venation. In this, the veins are interconnected with each other, just like the strands of a net. Examples of reticulate venation are on mango leaf, chiku, and hibiscus. In some plants, the veins branching from the midrib run parallel to each other, just like railway tracks. They do not form a network. This type of venation is known as parallel venation. All grasses, bamboo, palms, and the banana plant have parallel venation. So you may wonder what is important about venation. Interestingly, all the grains that we eat, like the rice and the wheat and millets, which are our main source of carbohydrates, have parallel venation. Similarly, all the pulses, like the Bengal gram and the pea, have reticulate venation. Veins not only are important for the plant, but they also help us to classify the plants into the two groups. The next time you see a leaf, do observe its venation.